A very good afternoon to everyone. On behalf of DD Gas 2020 Training Committee Chairman, Dr. G.N. Sastri, I welcome you all for today's first session. Today, we have an outstanding eminent scientist, Professor Vladimir Poraiko, with us to deliver the lecture in the first session. On behalf of Dr. G.N. Sastri, I thank you, sir, for accepting our invitation to deliver the lecture in DD Gas 2020 training program. Professor Vladimir Poraiko is the head Department of Bioinformatics, Institute of Biomedical Chemistry in Moscow, Russia. His research interest includes chemoinformatics, bioinformatics, and computer-aided drug design. He is one of the co-developers of Way2 drug platform, which provides a number of web resources such as PASS Online and GUSR Online and DIGEP PRET, CLC PRET, and so many other servers to predict the toxicity, drug likeliness of the compounds. I also would like to mention Professor Poraiko is closely working with Professor G.N. Sastri, and they have developed a common platform to predict the biological activity of the molecules. With this small introduction, I request Professor Vladimir Poraiko to deliver the lecture on computer-aided prediction of biological activity spectra for organic compounds, possibilities and limitations. Sir, please.
Thank you for your kind introduction. And I would like to express my sincere gratitude to Dr. Narahari Sastri for inviting me to present this lecture at the Drug Discovery Hackathon 2020. And in the past year, all humans celebrated the 150 years anniversary of the periodic law of chemical elements designed by Dmitry Mendeleev. And at the same time, actually, my team celebrated 30-year anniversary of computer program PASS, prediction of activity spectra for substances. As you may see, the first publication was in 1990, and PASS was actually developed at the old late 80s. The beginning of this story started in the framework of so-called state registration system for new chemical compounds synthesized in the USSR, which was arranged by Lev Piruzyan many years ago in the 70s of the past century. At that time, actually, all research institutes and universities in the Soviet Union were in the state ownership, and registration cards on new chemical compounds synthesized or extracted from natural sources were sent to the registration system. Each new chemical compound obtained a unique registration number. The most prospective compounds should be selected for biological testing, and the samples on the selected compounds were tested in biological assays. It is easy to assume that to retrieve all common information, it was necessary to have some computational systems that predict biological activity profiles for those compounds. Very important to mention that in the 70s, 80s of the past century, at that time, chemical compounds were synthesized by different chemists in different institutions with different purposes. Therefore, we may get significant heterogeneity of chemical classes of the compounds that were submitted to the state registration. And of course, most of the pharmacological experiments were performed in vivo or ex vivo. Therefore, pharmacological effects were observed at the organism's level of experimental animals that led to the potential variety of molecular mechanisms. As you may see from this slide, in 1989, we have only about 9,000 compounds in class training set, and about 100 of biological activity could be predicted with average accuracy about 74%. Currently, we have over 1 million biologically active compounds in the training set, and we are able to predict more than 8,000 types of biological activity, from which about 5,000 are recommended, and average accuracy of prediction is about 96%. Here you can see the interface, local version of PAS, with substances for which prediction is done, and here you can see the probabilities, probability to have activity, probability to not have activity, and the list of predicted biological activity. PAS is based on the concept of biological activity spectrum, which actually represents the set of different kinds of biological activity that reflect the result of compound interaction with various biological agents. Such approximation represents the intrinsic of the substance dependent on the therefore, we use the characteristics of molecular structure, which allowed us to combine the expression eight sources. Biological activity is predicted by PAS, the pharmacotherapeutic effects, and the protection. By the special integration of the charge particles to the ground structure, which is necessary at sufficient description of the structure. Actually, usage of such presentation of
excuse me, sir.
Yes.
I'm sorry to disturb you. Actually, your voice is not clear. You are not able to hear properly.
Sorry, what is not clear?
Yeah, your voice is not clear. When you are very close to the screen, we are able to hear properly.
You mean voice?
Yeah.
I try to be more loud. Yeah,
let's see. Now it is fine, sir.
It's okay?
Yeah, now it is fine.
Okay. So Dmitry Filimonov proposed so-called local correspondent concept, which is based.
Sorry. Excuse, sir, can you please share the screen again? We are not able to see the presentation.
Now you see it?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Please go ahead.
Okay. So it was proposed a local correspondent concept for which we designed the family of molecular descriptors called MNA, multi-level neighborhoods of atoms, QNA, quantitative neighborhoods of atoms, and LMNA, labeled multi-level neighborhoods of atoms. MNA's descriptors are used in PAS, QNA, in another computer program, GUSAR, and LMNA are used for prediction of metabolic transformations. So multi-level neighborhoods of atoms looks very simple. Zero level is the atom itself. First level is the atom and its closed neighborhood. Second level is the atom, its closed neighborhood, and the next neighborhood. As one may see, it's very close to the extended connectivity fingerprints, which are quite popular now, but they were published a few years later after our publication in Journal of Chemical Information and Computer Sciences. To form the models of structure-activity relationships, we use the modified naive bias approach. I will not go into detail of mathematical approach here, but you may read it in our publication on chemistry of heterocyclic compounds or in some other our publications. So to develop PAS, we collected information about known biologically active compounds from different sources. Then actually, due to the expert estimate, select the reliable data on structure and activity on drug-like molecules. Then we have the so-called PAS training set, perform the training procedure with our MNA descriptors and Bayesian algorithms. Then we have the knowledge base, which could be used for prediction for new molecules. Therefore, the structural formula of new molecule is submitted to the knowledge base, and then one gets the prediction results. It's necessary to stress that all this should work very consistently to provide the accuracy of the created SIR models and reliability of the predictions. You may imagine that creation of training set needs to combine the information from very different public sources. Partially they are publicly available, partially they are like Integrity or Reaxys are commercially available. Some of the sources are available only as a press release of companies or from some other databases. It's also information from some conferences and symposia, from patents, etc. Of course, to create the reliable training set, we need to follow the modern procedure for retrieval of the information. Such procedure was discussed by Professor Alex Tropsha from North Carolina University and described in many publications, which are listed on this slide. And we are following to this procedure in creation of our training set. Here you may see the example of PAS prediction and its prediction for well-known drug perindopril. One may see that antihypertensive action of this drug is predicted with reasonable accuracy, and PA value is about 0.6, PI value is about 0.005, and some other activities are also predicted. We will discuss it later. During the PAS development, actually, we performed a lot of comparative experiments. One experiment is given on this slide, so we compared the predictivity of MNA descriptors with many other descriptors generated by EMMA. That was a computer program designed by Nikolai Zefirov and his associates. And at that time, we see that predictivity was with MNA descriptors about 85%, with descriptors of EMA about 80%. When we combine both descriptors, we get just small improvement in comparison with the past. Therefore, we decided that this improvement is just negligible for a particular training set and particular activities. And we currently use only MNA descriptors for prediction. Another experiment was to investigate how the incompleteness of the training set influence on the performance of the program. Therefore, about 20,000 compounds from MDDR database were randomly split onto the training set and evaluation set, and then part of the information was randomly removed from the training set, and training procedure was done, and the accuracy of prediction was calculated. It was shown that even for the worst predicted activities, which you see on the left side of this picture, even if we exclude about 60% of hefty compounds, we still have reasonable accuracy of prediction. But of course, we have all compounds in the training set, we have poor reasonable accuracy. Another point that I would like to discuss is the selection of the cutoff, which actually depends on the task. In this slide, you can see two initial distribution functions for a particular biological activity. And of course, one can select very high threshold PPA value. In this case, it has very high chance of confirmation activity in the experiment, but low structural problem. Therefore, the found compounds may be very similar to the compounds from the training. If one select moderate threshold for selection of predicted activities, of course, the chance to get the activity in the experiment is lower, but it's moderate structural novelty of the selected compound. In case of low chance of activity and lower threshold, how they get high structural novelty to get the new chemical entity? Of course, selection of the cutoff depends on a particular task. And one should actually take into account also the possibilities for experimental testing. FAS could not apply it for any compound. There are some limitations. First of all, compounds must be fully determined without R or X. Then they should be single component. Two component compounds could not be used for prediction. They should not be charged. They should be neutral. They actually should have three or more carbon atoms. The molecular weight should correspond to so-called drug-like compounds. In general, those limitations correspond to the requirements that are described in the publications of Robson. Therefore, we are following to the current state of the art. It was actually not necessary to make predictions for all thousands of kinds of people. Select the desired subset of people. Therefore, for instance, one can approve the list of activities associated with rheumatoid arthritis. Probably it's more than one activity. And then get the predictive register just for those activities, 110 from all thousands. It is possible in past professional version to create a new surface. They see the number of substances that can edit something about the training set of this prediction is about 85%. But then we actually make selection the average accuracy of prediction for the other activity. Thus, what we have in red prediction perception.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, again, we are facing some problem. I mean, the voice is not clear in between. We are not able to hear in between.
I don't know what I can do. I actually speak loudly, very, very loud.
Yes, I understand. Can you come a little bit close to the monitor? I think that may be better.
Okay.
Is better? Yes. Fine, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Also, in PASS, one can perform 20-fold cross-validation. Then actually get the estimation of the predictivity. Usually, 20-fold cross-validation value is quite similar to those for leave-and-out cross-validation. That corresponds to the robustness of PASS algorithm that was shown in the experiments which I discussed before. Also, during the addition of new compounds to the PASS training set, you see that there is some quality control. Therefore, the two component or three component compounds are excluded. Compounds with charge are excluded, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Some errors are excluded as well. To analyze PASS prediction, we developed another program, which is called PharmaExpert. The author of this program is Alexey Lagunin, who is currently the head of bioinformatics department in Russian National Medical University. The input of PharmaExpert is PASS predicted activity spectra. And then it's possible to visualize the activity-activity relationships, for instance, between the appropriate effects and mechanism of action. Also in PharmaExpert, one can search for multi-targeted action. In this example, you can see that it's search for multi-targeted anti-neoplastic agents. And here you can see the output information about such agents. Also, there is some links to external resources like KEK, gene ontology, etc. In PASS, activity is predicted just in qualitative mode. Therefore, we developed another program called GUSAR, which creates the quantitative structure activity relationships models, and which was shown to have some advantages in comparison with many 2D or 3D methods applied for QSAR study. This program was developed by Alexey Zakharov, who is working in NCATS, NIH now. All our software is registered by Russian State Patent Agency. And I give you some just screenshots with some publications with application of PASS, PharmaExpert, and GUSA. And I would like to recommend you this consolidated review, QSAR Without Borders, which was published just recently in Chemical Society Reviews. Based on PaaS, we actually developed the first in the world web service for peer activity prediction. And for instance, Andreas Bender mentioned in his recent publication that one of the earliest and most widely used examples of data mining target elucidation is a continuously curated and expanded prediction of activity spectra for substances passed. One important reaction of finding new drugs is currently drug repurposing. It's particularly important in finding new drugs for treatment of SARS-CoV-2 COVID-19. And it's because the repurposed drugs be easily started directly in the clinical trial. Of course, it saves the money, yes, increase the chance of success. Keeping this in mind, jointly with Dr. Nara Hari-Sastri, we developed as a goal drug repositioning platform, which combined the predictive facilities of our team and Nara Hari-Sastri in PDF. Currently, we go further and develop over about 20 predictive web services specialistic. We have over 24,000 services appeared without predict biological spectrum of substance. We have permanently compared such services with our last slide tool. One publication
excuse me, sir. Sir, we are not able to hear properly. Sir, you please check whether your mic is mute or not. Your mic is mute or not, you please check, sir. Actually, I think your mic is. Yes, sir.
Now you hear me?
Sir, we are able to hear, but in between only the network only is the problem. We are able
now,
to hear.
Now you hear me?
Yes, I am able, we are able to see.
Okay. Thus, actually.
Sir, can you please share the screen again?
My God. Do you see it?
Yes, sir.
I should repeat the slide, probably.
Yes, sir, we are able to see.
Yes, okay. So, in our prediction, we actually find that some antihypertensive drugs, inhibitors on gatenzine converting enzyme, could have some nootropic effect or cognition enhancer effect. This prediction was confirmed in experimental tests on behavior of some experimental animals. It was shown that perindopril, quinopril, and monopril improved the patrolling behavior in dosage which are much less than those on piracetam and meclofenaxam. This prediction was further confirmed in clinical trials. Another example was done by our European colleague, Dr. Alexander Kell, in European project SysBioMed-IBD. Therefore, it was predicted that clarithromycin could be used for inflammatory bowel disease treatment. And this prediction was confirmed by experiment. Paper was submitted as preprint, and now it's in the authoritative journal under reviewing. Another example is prediction for some medicinal plants. It was done jointly with Professor Rajesh Goel from Punjabi University. Therefore, we investigated the phytoconstituents of Acheranthus aspera, which is one of the most popular medicinal plants that used in folk medicine in treatment of asthma, bleeding, etc. But antidepressant action of this medicinal plant was unknown. We predicted that phytoconstituents may have some mechanism of action which are associated with potential antidepressant action. And in pharmacological studies, Dr. Rajesh Goel confirmed these predictions. This paper was published, and this study was supported by a joint grant, supported by Russian Science Foundation and GST. Another example is virtual screen of the synthetic library that was performed by people of Piramal Pharma. So more than 2,000 organic molecules were predicted as potential xanthine oxidase inhibitors that could give the anti-hyperuremic effect. Some hits were selected for testing, and three compounds were shown to have activity close or even better than reference drug allopurinol. Another example is prediction of anti-aging mechanism of action and acetyl aspartate, which actually was done by Oriflame from Sweden. They make such predictions, and you can see that mechanism of actions are predicted with very small probabilities. However, almost all of these predictions were confirmed by the experiment. And paper was published in the International Journal of Cosmetics Science. Therefore, the appropriate anti-aging mechanism of action of N-acetyl aspartate were found. Currently, all people are under the challenge of SARS-CoV-2 COVID-19. And we have many, many publications, more than 27,000 publications just for half of the year. And you can see this on the Pablon website, which I open each day. And I started my day from reading the titles of new publications and then go to the abstracts of the selected publications and then go to some full publications, full text publications, which are currently available. Of course, in such extensive studies of SARS-CoV-2, we have many different knowledge, but a lot of knowledge are still unknown. We still have very, very limited information about many issues associated with SARS-CoV-2. Therefore, information that we have sometimes is incomplete, sometimes it's not certain, sometimes it requires a further confirmation and contradict one publication to the others. Now we have knowledge about the structure and replication cycle of this virus and can use it, this information for selection of some ligands that the entry into cell or replication process of this virus. Now we have some recommendations for treatment of this viral infection. But as you may see, some recommendations that were done a few months ago currently are considered as appropriate because in the further clinical trial, it was shown that these combinations of drugs like lopinavir, ritonavir, chloroquine, hydroxychloroquine do not the state of the patient. There are also some pharmaceuticals that were recently in Russia for treatment of this disease. You can see that they are reproduced drugs like favipiravir under different trade names, like also some monoclonal antibodies, which was created by BioCard, but you also may see that the just clinical trial starts to you. Very drug report. I'm trying to try to see any application. That's a thousand publications. Maybe one of the first publications that was published in March 2020 was the publication regarding the mode of action of anti-thrombotic. Therefore, it was shown first in Civica, then in Vitra, then that actually this the state of the patients. Yeah, by blocking the The SARS-CoV-2. You know now that just antiviral associated diseases, of course, the pathogenic factors like the times.
Excuse me, sir.
Sorry.
So your voice is breaking in between, actually. Can you just talk a little, from a little closer?
That's all what I can. Yeah.
This is perfect, sir. This is perfect.
It's a weak internet connection between India and Russia.
Okay, great.
I'm sorry.
So if you, from here, it's fine, sir. We are audible now, clearly. You can speak from this position only. It's clear now.
Okay, so we actually collaborate with Pharma COVID Center to provide some advices to clinical pharmacologists for treatment of a complex picture, not just antiviral blocking of entry into cells or its replication, but also some associated pathogenetic factors. Therefore, I try to show you, I don't know if you get it, that based on our long-term studies, we developed general computational method that predict with reasonable accuracy many biological activities just on the basis of structural formula of drug-like compound. We developed 20 web services that are widely used by over 24,000 researchers from 100 countries. More than 800 independent papers published with the appropriate citations. But of course, further development of these resources requires integration, curation of the information, improvement of functionality, etc. And of course, currently, all mankind are under the challenge of SARS-CoV-2 COVID-19. Which stimulates everybody to apply the available knowledge, experience, and facilities for combating this global threat. And we took part in this GEDIC Grand Challenge against COVID-19 that involved more than 100 teams to perform the virtual screening of potential anti-SARS-CoV-2 agents, more than 1 billion molecules. And of course, our full experience was used this challenge and cooperation between the researchers working in this field will be beneficial for all parties. With this, I would like to acknowledge my current team, particularly Dr. Dmitriy, Alexey Lakunin, and some others. My team members, some of them are currently working in FDA, NCATS, Thermo Fisher, Novo Nordisk, etc. Somehow, collaborators, including Dr. Sastry or Josh Goyle from me. Also, I would like to acknowledge the Russian patients that supported the licensees of our thank you for your kind attention. I hope that you get this something despite this patient.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
Thank you for your nice presentation on this PAS online, as well as how to do the small molecule drug discovery. And you have explained about the drug likeliness filters, all those things. Sir, actually, that we have received some couple of questions in the YouTube channel. So, okay. With your permission, can I ask?
Yes, please.
Yes, sir. Sir, you have mentioned about the M&A descriptors. Yes, student asks, can you please elaborate what is M&A descriptor?
M&A descriptors actually is very simple. Multi-level neighborhoods of atoms. It means that the zero level is the atom itself. First level is the atom and its closed neighborhood. Then the second level is atom, its closed neighborhood, and the next neighborhood. I can actually show in the slide once again. Let me go to this neighborhoods of atoms. Yes. So you see the slide?
Just 1 minute, sir.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So this is M&A descriptors, as you can see in the slide. M&A descriptors. And there is publication in Journal of Chemical Information and Computer Sciences in 1999, which describes the M&A descriptors. And as I actually stressed, it's very close to extended connectivity fingerprints that were published a few years later. Okay?
Yes.
Please, next question.
Yes, sir. One more student, he asked, can I use the PASS online server to predict off-target binding of a lead compound?
Sorry, after?
Off-target binding affinity of a lead compound. Off-target effect of the compound.
PASS online web service is able to predict the probability that particular compounds that were submitted for prediction interact with about 4,000 different targets or exhibit some pharmacological effects. It's actually estimates the probability that compound is belonging to the subset of actives or inactives, but it is not predicted the affinity to the particular target or actually quantitative characteristic of the effect. It's just prediction of belonging to the classes of actives or inactives compounds respectively.
Thank you, sir. Welcome. Sir, there is another question. Is there any commonality has been observed among the structure of all the approved COVID-19 drugs?
Could you please repeat?
I mean, is there any commonality has been observed?
Yeah. You mean coincidence between different approved drugs? I don't get the question. Please.
No, sir. I mean, any commonality among the structure of all the approved drugs?
Is there something common between the structures of approved drugs?
Yes, yes, all the approved drugs.
Actually, of course, there is some commonality. Yeah. There is something common because all they are consisted from the atoms. All they included the carbon atom, etc., etc., etc. But of course, to exhibit the selectivity and different effects, approved drugs should actually have some difference in the structures. But of course, there are some similarity. For instance, if you have, for instance, antihypertensive drugs or inhibitors on a particular enzyme, etc.
So thank you very much, sir. So before concluding this session, I request our DDS 2020 Training Committee Chairman, Dr. G.N. Shastri, to give his remarks.
I don't hear you.
Sir, we are not able to hear.
No.
There is some technical issue over there. Sir, actually, I think there is a technical problem over there.
I see.
So just since he is not able to join, I would like to thank you, sir, on behalf of DDS 2020 Training Committee, to spend your valuable time to enlighten all the participants who is participating in the DDGATS 2020 training, as well as who is participating over there in the drug discovery hackathon against COVID-19. So on behalf of Dr. G.N. Shastri, once again, I thank you, sir, for sparing your time and giving your valuable lecture to all of us. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, and thanks to all. Good luck in your research to fight the COVID-19 challenge. Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. Bye, sir.